Camilla.
And I'm Kang, and we are
the Fire Resellers. And we have a haul for you.
It was an estate sale that I went to, and it was the last hour of the last day, and they gave me a deal. I spent $84 for all of these items, and it came to about $2 and some per item. So it was great. Mm-hmm. This was a very high-end home, and we're very excited to show you this haul. So let's get into it. I've got two hard goods that I just want to go through real quick. This camera lens, it's Vivitar. I did not look it up. I decided to grab it anyway. I can get like $15 or $20. I've got to do a little bit more research on it, but for such a massive thing, I felt like it was going to be pretty good no matter what. Turns out it's just okay. At least it's made in Japan, so that's usually a sign of quality. So we'll get a pretty decent amount for this. Here we've got a surge protector, you know, with these all these outlets. Technically, it's supposed to come with this backup battery in the back, but I saw that you can sell it for $30 on eBay without the battery. So that's great because having to ship a battery, I think, also is very complicated.
Yeah.
So hopefully we'll get about $30 for this. Okay, going into the shoes and clothes, we've got a pair of Salvatore Ferragamos. Now, these are men's, and they look like they've been kept in really good condition, mm-hmm. relatively speaking, considering how worn it is on the bottoms. Mm-hmm. Now, this is pretty worn, and generally, I would not have picked it up if it were any more expensive than, let's say, $5. But overall, Salvatore Ferragamos for this amount is pretty good. I think that anyone who wants to buy Salvatore Ferragamos will probably pay at least $40. Mm-hmm. We've had some pretty good luck with Salvatore Ferragamos in the past. Mm-hmm. It just kind of depends on the condition and stuff.
Yeah.
This one, I think we'll have to take less than, you know, the max.
This is nice because this is a size 13D. And so with Ferragamos, you always want to check the width. So D is like a medium width on men's. And then we picked up a lot, well, I say we, I wasn't there. Kang picked up a lot of women's Ferragamo shoes. So we're going to go through these kind of quickly since we got five pairs of women's ones.
A lot.
But these are mostly double A, which is like a narrow size. So A is narrow, double A is like double narrow, and then triple A is like super duper narrow. So you want to be on the lookout for that because I feel like I find Ferragamos more often in the narrow width than in just like a medium width.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not really sure why that is. Like, did women, you know, in the 80s have, you know, skinnier feet? I'm not really sure.
Are they squeezing themselves into skinnier or narrower shoes?
I think maybe not as many people have narrow feet as they used to, or maybe people just don't know that they have narrow feet because so many brands don't have narrow sizes as much anymore. You know, most brands just make kind of the one width and then they have like a wide width.
These are
and that's
cool.
about it. These are like a little alligator almost, alligator skin, snake skin.
Snake skin, maybe?
Yeah.
So, what does that remind you of? Anyway, the saving grace, aside from the narrow feet, is that they're 9.5, which is a pretty decent size. That's like almost average, right?
Yeah.
About average for women's sizes.
Yeah, the most common women's size is a size 9, so 9.5 is pretty close. And so that's pretty good.
The bottoms of these are pretty good. Mm-hmm. A lot of these have great bottoms. So overall, I grabbed as many as I could that were in good condition.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of these were pretty decent enough.
Mm-hmm.
And they had a lot of interesting like leather detailing. And then we've got another pair of men's Salvatore Ferragamos.
Mm-hmm.
So 7 pairs of Salvatore Ferragamo. This one is a toe cap style. It's pretty nice. Like the other men's pair, also in pretty good condition, kept pretty well, but worn at the bottom. So just something that kind of comes with age. And it seems like this guy had a lot of high-end things and wore a lot of high-end suits and went to a lot of, you know, events and stuff. So he probably had just these few because black is very classic, you know, goes with almost everything. So overall, pretty good. I also got these Stuart Weitzmans. Now, these had a lot of dust on them. I wasn't sure. I asked Camilla if she wanted me to get some. She said only if they looked interesting. And this is pretty interesting.
Yeah.
So it's got like this zebra print in a yellowish brown color. And it is leather and it's made in Spain. So I thought that that was an indicator of pretty good quality. So I decided to pick it up.
Yeah, and these are pretty, this is a pretty trendy style. I see, you know, teeny boppers on TikTok wearing this. So I think this will be a good pickup.
All right, 1 point for me.
By
the way, so Camilla and I went to two separate ways of sourcing this one day. And we'd like for you to watch both of these videos.
Yeah.
This one being the estate sale and hers being a bins haul that same day. And you let us know who got the better stuff, because mm-hmm. both of these hauls were amazing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it's Kang versus Camilla. Leave your vote down below. Well, not yet, because this one will come out first, so you have to wait for mine. But then once you do, leave your vote down below in the comments so that you can, you know, we can just bask in whoever wins. He's hoping it's him.
Yeah, I'm hoping it's me because I've got all these cool things. Yeah. But anyway, she got a lot of great stuff too. Yeah. So we've already done inventory on both of these. Now, these are a pretty newish pair of nails. They have hardly been worn and the bottoms look excellent. They've got a really nice style.
I like a slide style. And then it's got a little bit of elastic here mm-hmm. with these. I don't know if these are leather or faux leather, but they've got like this little jewel there. Very cute, very mm-hmm. stylish. Just a small little wedge, and these cork sandals are always pretty good, and especially if they're in really good condition, yeah. which these are. They're like basically new.
Yeah, I feel the like, bottoms so. Remind me of Birkenstock, so yeah. it's got that same vibe mm-hmm. for sure. Okay, two more pairs of shoes. Now, this one, Asics, I didn't really look up because they're in really good condition. I imagine that this lady used these more for walking than running mm-hmm. because the bottoms have great tread. These have been worn pretty well because of the inside on the insoles, but the treads are not so worn. So that tells me that they're pretty good for resale, and I'm hoping to get at least 25. I mean, personally, I like Asics, so it's just one of those things where I picked it up because I know the brand. The last pair of shoes, these are really big, like the other ones, 13, and this is a pair of Adidas golf shoes. The bottoms are in great condition. The spikes are all there and they're not broken, so that's always a good thing. Otherwise, mm-hmm. it really lowers the value because the person will have to replace them.
Right.
But otherwise, I think we can get like $80 for these, and that would almost pay for the haul itself. Overall, really great haul of shoes. Mm-hmm. Now, let's show you all the other cool things. So I've got three packs of Christian Dior tights. Now, I thought that these would be worth something because I thought vintage Christian Dior mm-hmm. things would be worth something. But yeah. it turns out all three of these together will probably only fetch like $7.
It's kind of tough because with these, you don't know if the elastic is shot because they're so old mm-hmm. or, you know, what. And so we have had some bad experience selling, you know, unopened vintage items where it's like somehow damaged inside from storage. And we don't know because we didn't open it because mm-hmm. that would lower the value. But then the buyer gets it and is unhappy with it. So that is something to be careful with stuff like this, that, you know, if it's still in the package, that doesn't mean that it's like in new condition because of the age of storage. So just something to be wary of.
Okay, I'm going
to
go through all the clothing now. I think mm-hmm. that this is really the cream of the crop. I got a lot of great stuff, I feel like.
You are not going to believe what's in here.
So mm-hmm. as you can tell with the shoes, it was both men's and women's things that I picked up. Mm-hmm. The lady had some really nice high-end brands, mm-hmm. and I can only imagine what other people picked up before I had got there,
mm-hmm.
because, like I said, it was the last hour of the last day. So this first one is Escada, and let me tell you, I got a lot of Escada stuff. So mm-hmm. this one, just pretty basic skirt,
mm-hmm.
not bad. The brand itself, we know, is a pretty high-end brand. Mm-hmm. We did consider sending it to the Real Real, but I don't think we're going to do that. We'll probably try to sell ourselves.
Yeah.
Now, a pretty basic tank top, but mm-hmm. it's exclusively Missook. So, mm-hmm. pretty good brand. Missook, not mm-hmm. to be confused with Missook.
Yeah. Don't confuse those. Major difference in resale value.
That's one of the reasons why I remember that this is a pretty good brand. Missook is something to be on the lookout for. Uh-huh. Now, it's basic, but I still think that we can get, mm-hmm. like, at least $20 for it.
Mm-hmm. So, Missook, Escada, and then St. John, they're kind of, I kind of think of those as together, like mm-hmm. three that are kind of together, because they're sort of, you know, more mature brands, that sort of thing. And so it makes sense that this lady had these two brands, and we also got a St. John thing. So.
Yeah. Now we've got Eileen Fisher kind mm-hmm. of in that same
vein, mm-hmm. you know.
So this is a really nice sweater, jacket, full zip.
Yeah.
Eileen Fisher, we pick up pretty much every time we have a chance from the bins. Mm-hmm. So to me, this was mm-hmm. a great pickup.
I mean, Kang was there. He didn't know how much it was going to actually be per item.
Mm-hmm.
He just kind of put everything in a pile and then the guy gave a price. And it turned out to be $2 per item. But you probably thought it was a little bit more, right?
When
you were buying
it. I thought it was going to be more. But I also strategized where I had a maybe pile. I knew that I was going to get a certain amount. And just the pile that he said was about $60, and then there was another pile of about $20. I think to seal the deal, he didn't want to put all the maybe stuff back. So he really gave it to me for a pretty good price. And it even started at $90. And I said, hey, could you do anything about the price? He said, okay, $80. So I did negotiate, and it was really nice because it was the last day and they probably wanted to get rid of as much stuff as they possibly could. Mm-hmm. So that's probably one of the reasons why I got a good deal. I don't know that we're going to do this strategy a whole lot, but we're probably going to try it a few more times because this turned out to be really lucrative.
Yeah.
Now, we haven't even gotten to the best stuff yet, but this one is St. John's Sport. And just by the look of it, it's not a whole lot.
Yeah.
But I feel like we can get at least $25 for it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it doesn't look like regular St. John. You know, St. John is known for the knit, like the Santana knit style. And this is just like a t-shirt, you know, material. But someone will want it, I'm pretty sure. Like that, the sequins, you know?
I picked up this really nice reversible quilted jacket. It's like unbranded, but I feel like we are kind of into that. And Camilla maybe wants to wear it a few times. So
we'll see. I love quilted jackets. So. Yeah.
So really nice design. And I thought that, you know, being reversible, it really adds to the value at least a little bit. So another Eileen Fisher piece. It's a double-breasted jacket. It's pretty light. It's got a nice, what is this, like canvas feel to it.
Yeah, twill.
I picked it up thinking Eileen Fisher, nice material.
Cute color. I like the color too.
So we'll take it. So another Misuk piece. Just a basic black open front cardigan. It's got shoulder pads. We can either take those out or just sell them as is. But this is kind of an older piece.
Might have even been a set with that tank top, like you wear it together. Yeah, I don't know.
Maybe. This one is Escada E Sport. And it is just a pair of pants.
Yeah.
Not terrible.
Like just some chinos.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah.
Basic. Decided to pick it up anyway. It was kind of in my maybe pile. I wasn't sure if I was going to get it. But he gave me a good price. Got a paisley skirt by Abercrombie and Fitch. And this is a really interesting tag.
I would not have guessed that this skirt was from Abercrombie & Fitch. It must be from, like, very vintage Abercrombie & Fitch, because that is not the Abercrombie & Fitch that I've ever been to, like, in the mall.
Right?
You know, they were not selling this when I was in middle school, walked through the mall.
Yeah.
So, we'll have to see what that is like. We've sold some vintage Abercrombie & Fitch, but the kind that we've sold has been more, like, 90s vintage, and that seems even older than that.
Okay, so we got a few Escada pieces. These blazers are really nice. This one's double-breasted. It's got a little bit of yellowing around the collar, but otherwise in pretty good condition.
Yeah.
And this is Escada Margarita Lay. I looked up the comps when I was there, and they seem to be doing pretty well with these blazers. And even as vintage blazers go, they are doing pretty okay. So we got this other Escada piece.
This one is interesting because it's kind of like asymmetrical. Kind of goes like this. It's really cute. So I like that one a lot. This lady loved Escada.
Yeah, this one, double-breasted Escada Margarita Lay again. And this is like a power suit. Or that's what I think when you see like a vertical stripe suit for a lady.
Working hard. Working hard down the city.
Yeah.
You know.
To me, this is probably in style because there are so many functions.
I think so.
Something like this.
I was thinking that this one, I could see people wearing it and styling it in kind of a modern way. So definitely, I think this one will sell.
Yeah, I know a little bit.
Yeah. He's picking it up. Picking it up, you know.
So moving on to some of these cooler items for men's. We've got a Brioni two-piece suit. The first time we have picked up Brioni.
Yeah.
And this can go for like $200.
Like at least.
At least.
Yeah.
The two-piece. So this guy was a huge guy. Size 13 shoes. And this is like humongous suit. So my thought on this is that when it comes to tailored suits, you can size down when you get it fitted, but you can't add material, right? So this guy being so huge, there's a lot of material to work with. It might not be ideal for a tailor to cut down so much of it, but you can still work with it.
Yeah. I mean, like, an average size guy or a bigger guy might be able to buy this, but like some, you know, slim Jim, no, he's out.
Yeah. So speaking of Brioni, we've got a Brioni tie. I was like, oh my gosh, this is so good. So here's the tag. This is something to be on the lookout for. Now, the tie is only going for about $20 and the sell-through rate is not great, but the actual suit, you definitely want to be on the lookout for. So there's the tag for you, just so that you can see it and kind of burn that into your brain.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yep. Okay, we've got a suit jacket by Ralph Lauren. It's the purple label.
Yeah.
You definitely want to be looking at purple label Ralph Lauren and looking it up, seeing what it's worth, because it's a higher end label for Ralph Lauren. So it's 95% wool and 5% cashmere.
Nice.
Just great. Just high quality. We can't go wrong with this. So another suit jacket. This one is just one piece, and it is by Armenegildo Zegna at Neiman Marcus. This is the first time that we've picked up a suit jacket by this brand. I think that it's a pretty good brand. I did not look this up because I figured that most of these things are high quality and high end enough. This guy had pretty much all high end stuff, but it is 100% wool. That is one thing that I do care about when I pick up suits and suit jackets, is that it's at least wool.
Yeah.
You don't want to get polyester. You don't want to get that rayon stuff. That stuff doesn't sell very well.
Yeah, because then you just start sweating in it, you know? And then you start to smell. And you can't be smelling at dinner meetings and stuff
high-end
like that.
Functions.
You know?
Just can't do it.
Yeah. Trying to close the deal with clients. You can't be stinky.
It also says, fine, worsted, super 100s.
Now, super 100s.
We've talked about supers in a previous video, but just the higher the supers is, the number, usually it's like 120s, 140s. This one says just 100. The higher it is, the better. So something to think about. Now, a two-piece suit. Mm-hmm. Ralph Lauren, purple label.
Yeah.
Wow. Look at that. Yeah. So we will see what this goes for, but I just know that it's going to sell well. The brand, the label, two-piece suit.
And this one is 60% wool, 30% mohair, and 10% cashmere. So very good materials.
Just crazy. And I don't think that that's even the best thing. Okay, so we've decided to move this over to the end. It's going to be a good one.
Yeah.
This one is also a good one, though. This one is Burberry's. This guy had so much good stuff. I'm pretty confident that this is real. I have no reason to doubt. So I'm pretty sure this is real.
I mean,
Burberry's.
Like, he was in his house. Like, he knows what kind of life this guy was living, you know?
So they had like a three-story house in a very high-end area of Houston. So I have no doubts that this is real, but we definitely want to be careful regardless. Yeah. And, you know, with high-end stuff, you always got to be careful.
Yeah, and in the pocket of one of these suit jackets, we found receipt to the country club. So we definitely know that this guy was living the high life.
High life. Okay, another one. Ralph Lauren, purple label, two-piece suit.
There you go.
Are you jealous yet? And you're thinking, wait, Camilla had a Benz haul that was as good or better than mine?
I know. Can you believe it?
Can you believe it? So we really got lucky on this day. Just crazy. So this is one of the better pieces.
It's 100%
wool. There you go. So quality material. So this is just a long sleeve button up. It's a window pane pattern, and it's the Armenegildo Zegna again. This one, I'm pretty sure we've done comps in the past. This is probably only going to go for about $20, $25, but, you know, I picked it up anyway. Oh, you want to keep skipping that one?
Yes, to the very end, so people stay tuned, you know? Fine.
Okay, so Chico's design, we don't pick up a whole lot of Chico's, but Chico's design and Chico's, like, 3X, usually we pick up. And this one had a great design to it, so I figured we'd pick it up. It does have a spot on it.
But we're going to wash it.
We're going to wash it. Hopefully we'll get it out. I do like the design just in general. Even if it weren't Chico's, I probably would have picked it up.
Yeah, it's very cool. I like the design too. I like, you know, it's very modern. Like, you could see this from Free People or something like that. Mm-hmm. So I do like this design.
Extra bonus, it is size 3. So that's like double whammy.
Double
awesome.
Whammy.
Okay, another St. John piece. We put this near the end because we need to like really clean this and try to get this yellowing out.
Yeah.
It's just in rough shape, but St. John, I couldn't pass it up. This was in the maybe pile. It's also got
a little double-breasted.
This going on. It's tough.
Yeah.
So we'll see if we can get that out. Maybe some OxyClean, maybe some
RetroClean.
Yeah, maybe some RetroClean. Overall, pretty nice.
It's very cool, very
knitted,
80s.
Yeah.
Yeah, 90s style.
Got these really cool buttons too.
Yeah.
Now this, I could not pass up. It's got this stain here. It's in really rough shape, but look at this thing. It's got the map of the world on it, and it's, embroidered, and it's got just a lot of these things that, you know, will indicate what is at these continents. So, pretty fun.
Mm-hmm.
Not so sure that we'll be able to sell it for very much. I just couldn't pass it up.
You think Kang should wear this?
It's a women's piece, but I maybe I can
pull
it off.
It's a women's piece, really?
Yeah, it's got these shoulder pads,
no
too.
Way.
Yeah, it's Suzelle. It's by the brand Suzelle. I don't know. I didn't even look it up because I figured it's cool enough. Somebody's going to want it.
Yeah. Yeah. Let us know what you would have done.
Famous last words?
Comments. Yeah. Okay. Final piece.
Final piece. This is 100% cashmere. This is Laurel Piana.
Yes. So something that has been on our bolo list for a really long time. We
100% wanted to find it. Worsted spun cashmere. Now, the only thing that is kind of like, you know, not great is that it's Hart Schaffner Marks. Now, this is a brand that we don't exactly pick up, but it is Gold Trumpeter, and it's 100% cashmere. You can't really pass that up. And it's Laurel Piana cashmere. Now, we've never come across anything that has Laurel Piana, like anything. So this is something to be on the lookout for. Definitely a bolo material, and just something to
keep in mind.
This is very old Dillard's, and this not great. So but you know, not bad. We've seen a lot of Hart Schaffner Marks, and we don't ever really pick it up, but we could not let this go. I feel like we blazed through that, and hopefully you like the pace of this video, because we're just really excited. But also, there are a bunch of duplicates of the brands.
Yeah, so that's what happens when you get, you know, from all one person or two people in this case. So it's a lot of the same kind of stuff, which is nice, because then, you know, you can kind of move quickly as you're listing items. Like with all of these suits, I can, you know, kind of batch them all together and work pretty quickly through those listings. So that's great. I love doing that. And we're really excited about this haul. So you'll have to stay tuned for my haul to see, you know, who's better, who got the better haul that day. And we are just so excited. So if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. That helps YouTube show this video to more people, and we just love that. And if you aren't subscribed, consider subscribing so you don't miss my haul and any of the other videos that we put out, including, you know, getting you updated on what of these have sold in our What Sold videos. We'd love to have you as part of our YouTube community.
Yeah, we'll see you later.
Bye.
Another Eileen Fisher piece. This is a double-breasted kind of coat.
Yeah.
Light jacket. Light jacket. Okay.